tap into and use that nuclear reactor of energy. I'll say for some of us that Omicron monsters, I'll say that for some of us, the energy won't be nuclear, but for me it is. And by that I mean that I know I have a lot of hate and insecurity built up in me. And I could easily say, oh man, I'm so depressed. Oh my goodness, life's not fair. I should be making more sales. I deserve more. My doggies deserve the best, biggest front yard, backyard, ranch, sanctuary, dog food possible. Life's unfair. I could think that, I could say that, I could cry that up to the heavens. That's not gonna do squat. And I keep working on this because it adds to my collection of work. There is 0.00000 infinite zero chance that I'm gonna make a buck off of this design. I'll find a customer for it, make a sale for it. And I was watching this video with Grant Cardone. Dan Pena, Jordan Peterson. But and some other dude was stating as to how when you get better at something, more successful, more leaner, healthier. Another video I wanted to make was, if people are gonna hate you, let them hate you for being happy, healthy, and successful. That's gonna be the remix of this video. And today in the dog walk, where I was thinking, fuck man, I have to do logistics, planning, advertising, quality control, manufacturing, distribution, sales, and design. And then to fill in the gaps, these are YouTube videos. But the good thing about these YouTube videos, it's probably another video by itself, is that YouTube tracks progress. Again, one thing that's happened to me a lot in my life is, oh dog, you want to do a business? I want to do a business too. Oh man, you want to travel and do this? Oh man, I got an idea. I got everything, man. Clothing lines, stickers, any kind of business, any sort of shop. We're doing one too. Go to this country, that country. Fuck all these bitches and meet these celebrities and whatever, be a model. What else? Be famous. And to me, don't think that I wasn't that stupid into also believing that. You know what? I also want to be famous. Get some water here. Until I realized, wait, be famous for what? What the fuck am I going to be famous for? then also thought, what am I mean, famous for? And what good does that fame do? Eventually, I thought, you know what the best thing about fame would be? Is the audience. You could sell a fart in a jar. And what's it called? Salty Cracker, I believe, is a YouTube channel. I saw, posted a video of a chick that sells her farts online, and I'm like, what the fuck? Fuck it. If she's making a buck off of that, her, she's got to be a top three. What the fuck moments that inspired me. She's one of them, this chick. She wasn't like hella delicious. She was cool, but nothing like, nothing like Steph Kegels. That's a badass bitch right there. What was it? See, taking a booty. This chick. Oh yeah, so this chick. Not even proper thick, a little thick. And the Island Boys, these guys, these three numbskulls, they're all getting paid more than I am. Or even this mother and daughter who have an OnlyFans. And I'm thinking, at least one of them has got to be a fucking badass, fucking delicious bitch. Like, no, they look like, what do you call them? Truckers call them parking lot lizards. Not lizards. But yeah, seeing these people in action, I'm thinking, yeah, you know what, there's a market out there for just about anything, just about. Just go sell it. I'm just thinking, where... I keep repeating that. But this is the hardest thing of the whole business thing is creating. Yeah, but along this journey, started thinking of what they said on this YouTube video where people will try to sabotage you. They will. They're gonna hate on you. And it's because they see your progress. They see you doing something that they're too cowardly to fucking attempt to try to do. But me, myself, I'm a bit fucked up. Not a bit, a whole lot of fucked up with my way of thinking. Sometimes I think, what's the whole point, man? I don't have no wife or kids. Being a bit selfish right now because I got toys I would give to the Kentucky Tornado Fund, but almost thinking that fucking the governor bitch. I'm pretty sure, I'm just guessing here, they have a few more nickels than I do, but I know where to shop for toys. Anything, fucking tobacco products, fucking. Salami, spaghetti sauce, dog toys, underwear. And Aunt Billy, I'm so sorry, sir. My only deal to donate these toys is if I could be there and see the smile. I don't give a fuck about the fucking price. Well, fuck, I got, at least have this, man. Fucking a place, fucking a dry place that hasn't been blown over by a tornado that still has electricity. I can make some more money. Not make, earn some more money. The Fed already makes money. And there's a storm moving in right now from to Nebraska. See how the fuck that does. Yes, I'm selfish like that. I want to see the happiness. I want the credit for work done. No, not even the Salvation Army with its fucking making a pamphlet in about with critical race theory and racism in America. I'm thinking, what the fuck? I'm not gonna fuck. No, I'm not gonna fucking support a fucking terrorist, fucking brainwashing company like that. Well, I knew it. I knew you were an asshole. People say, well, don't live here to Los Angeles. A lot of poor people here. I'm thinking, you motherfucker. I've seen homeless. Well, supposedly. I don't even know if they're homeless. But they're beggars. I know that. Because these two fucking annoying motherfuckers that always gotta fuck with me whenever I'm grocery shopping or buying coffee or buying my refill at Starbucks for 50 cents. Hey man, you got a dollar, motherfucker. How about spare change, huh? Fucking dollar. But anyway, they started with some fucking new Jordans. I'm like, this bitch. Ain't no shame in the game, yo. Fuck, I'm not gonna enable that. I've seen it more than once where people that are on government assistance fucking have nicer shit than me. And that's okay. Because the politicians also fucking take shit from everyone. From a lot of motherfuckers. Such is life. Yeah, but the Kentucky's governor's wife is making a toy shop, I'm thinking. You know, if I'm set, if my mansion is set, and the people who voted me in or gave me power or that I'm in charge of. Oh no, I'm gonna give away my Christmas bonus to them. No, they can't, because you know, these other people gotta get more too. It's all a racket. Lately, I've been operating more by myself. A lot less headaches. It has affected my sales, but you know what? Peace of mind. Totally worth it. Totally worth it. Knew that it would grow up to be in the Twilight Zone episode. I saw something disturbing today, but homeless dude, by this one tree that I was, we just don't walk down the street on my dog. So, hey, let's walk, let's explore. I could tell that his clothes were, well, he was dry, but I could tell that he had layers of clothing on him or blankets on him, and it soaked up a lot of rain. I just got out of his way, so I don't want. I could tell that he saw me coming with my big dogs. What do I do? I can go mad. I'm actually, I am going mad because there's just so much to do here, so much. From sweeping the sidewalk that keeps on getting littered every day, to the homeless who just keep mounting up, mentally ill, to crime. One dead body, two dead bodies, three dead bodies, war. And those are the ones that just stand out. Four dead bodies. One of them gunned down. Two gunned down. One runned over. Fourth are just a body dumped. Same area where someone tried to assault me and rob me. Two different occasions. One by a Negro, one by, I think, looked like a white dude. Yeah, and that's a, yeah, that's a, I'm not a much of a fucking guy. Oh my goodness, let's take a selfie. I'm like, no fucking. Our city is literally falling apart. When I was thinking too about the rain up in San Francisco, that fucking tower, I think what is it sank another 4 inches in the last fucking month or something like that. Thinking of the fucking rain, hell yeah, it's got the wind. Would insure my home, my condo across the street. Probably buy like a yeah, no doubt that it's going to be a racket there. Someone's Picasso's going to be destroyed in that building collapse. Life insurance. All sorts of shit. Fucking built on a fucking, what was it, a clay foundation? I don't know that. That's why Mexico City is gets destroyed during earthquakes because it was a big lake that was filled in by the Aztecs centuries ago. Maybe that's the payback, you know, from the Spaniards that took over. I'm a lucky cunt, man. I think the other. Video again. So also on this dog walk, I was remembering the time when I'll share something with you, an intimate time with my soul. Mm-hmm. You know what? When I earned that title, I thought, damn, you know what? I'm growing. Like, man, I've been such an ignorant little bitch. A naive motherfucker. A nasty piece of shit. And I thought that by the time I graduated boot camp, that, man, for some reason I feel that everyone else has been enlightened because what I did in 3 months, whatever, 3.5 months, however the fuck long boot camp is. I recommend you do that during the holidays with Thanksgiving and Christmas. Why? Because it'll be a day off. Shit, fuck the fucking presents or gifts or being thankful. You need fucking another day off to rest your fucking feet. Especially for chicken legs like mine. Make little spaghetti arms when they join. But I was thinking today, because as I felt that I've hit rock bottom here, and how I got here, I thought, you know, I got here because the celebration is over from the Marine Corps, because at that time, I was just out of high school, so they didn't know shit. I still don't know shit, but it's amazing when someone will pat you on the back like, oh man, we always knew you could do it. Oh man, that's amazing. Chill out. Relax. Oh, here's some fast food. Remember the first time I had Jack in the Box when I got out? Oh my goodness, I felt like I was choking, suffocating. All that greasy ass shit. Lost my appetite. I took a couple of bites and I stopped. But it's funny when people are like, yeah, man, you can do it. I always knew you can do it, man. You're the best. Or, it's amazing, inspirational. And the same people, you know, now that I have a couple hundred bucks in my pocket, yeah, you're the best. You're a Marine now. You fucking got money. And this is before I traveled. Fucking picked up 1, 2, 3, 4 more careers. Lived and worked in over 100 cities throughout a few countries. And, you know, from that time, it's amazing that people that call themselves friends and family at that point in time are like, oh, you shouldn't be doing this because what if you fail? What if you get killed? What if you get robbed? What if you lose money? What if? 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 Da, 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 da. And for me, it cost me a lot of money because I was reluctant to pull the trigger when the opportunity was best. And one thing is that I'm glad I got a lot of shit done before COVID. I don't think we're ever going to go back to normal. If we do go back to normal, let me write that down, actually. We will go back to normal after Civil War, then Revolutionary War. I'm just flashing back to times where I had a feast. But no one, not one swinging dick, not one motherfucker. Not one bitch that was fucking dating or fucking. I said, yo, man, you could do it. Good luck, man. You can be the best. As I'm doing my road trips across the Western world and by myself. Place I've never been to by myself. Well, yeah, don't think that I'm fucking here. Again, I gotta remind people. Because you'll say, oh my goodness, you're making terrorist threats. You're gonna fucking commit violence. I'm like, hell fucking no. Hell no. Hell no. Nope, 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 nope. This I feel about most of America, majority of it. One time I was going to a Starbucks to get my coffee with the coffee refill. If I was really quick, I could drink two refills and then save the third one for later. So three for the price of one and a half. Remember, I'm walking in there, and this, you know, decent black chick, solid 7.5. Out of 10. And it's walking out. I open the door for her. She's on her phone. She sees me looking at her like, mm-mm-mm. God gave you a little more attention with your design. But then say nothing. Just like, mm-mm-mm. I remember she rolled her eyes at me like, what the fuck are you, you broke ass motherfucker? You ain't coming in here no drive through Bugatti. I can't afford this pussy. Mm-hmm. That's the kind of look she gave me, right? Rolled her eyes and saying, all right, you fucking bitch. Just a cum dumpster. Have a nice day. Fuck off. Die slow. I know you're a psychopath. But anyways, one of the neighborhood homeless, mentally ill motherfuckers rolls up on her. She's sitting outside in the patio. And there's other fucking big motherfuckers around there too. I don't think I'm the only motherfucker there. And he starts talking shit to her, yeah, does this, and then fucking starts swinging at her. And I'm thinking, you know, that bitch, she attracted that with her negative attitude. Let's see, I want to see this boss bitch, this badass bitch, handle this motherfucker, because the way she gave me that those looks. She knows that she's prestige on top of the food chain, and let her show me that I ain't at her level, yo. But no, that bitch is looking, ah. So anyways, yeah, that'll be America. And me, I'll just be like, yeah, venti coffee, please. Can you get a refill now? Can you get a cup of water for my doggy too? And yeah, that'll be me. No, I'm not gonna say La Revolución, viva la Resistance. No, I'm cool. You can have that. But if one of my brothers needs me, well, that's a different story. But we also know that, you know, we gotta let everyone else collapse, be whipped harder, whipped into rebellion. For there to be change. But yeah, we're not gonna get in trouble for a bunch of weak fucking pansy motherfuckers. Nope, we are not. And oh no, what are you gonna do? Fucking cut up the food at the supermarkets, oh no. Restaurants, oh my goodness, we're gonna eat canned food, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, you knocked that power, oh my goodness. I'm gonna have to sleep with another blanket. Oh my goodness, you knocked off water. Oh my goodness. Now fuck that. Hit me. I'm ready for it. I'll be patient. I'll let the whole everyone fucking start murdering each other for a baby formula, bottled water, a phone charger, Wi-Fi, a toy for their kid for Christmas. Yeah, everything. All that shit's coming. All that shit's coming, dude. And me, I'm just gonna, keep looking broke, keep looking hungry. My goodness. Look, such is life. Which is this little part. That's it for now, motherfuckers. Trump Rittenhouse, 2024. And remember, when the going gets tough, let's go, Brandon.